When you receive a meeting invitation, you can respond in line, in the reading pane. Or open the invitation in a separate window and use the commands in the respond command group. These are the same commands, just in a slightly different layout. There are a number of response options available for responding to a meeting request. Use Accept to accept the meeting invitation and place the meeting on your calendar. You can choose to accept and send a response to the meeting organizer. This response will simply say that you accept the meeting and its time. You can choose to accept and not send a response to the meeting organizer, or accept and edit the response to include information in a message to the meeting organizer. As the invitee, when you accept or click send, the accepted meeting invitation item gets moved from your message list and added to your calendar. As the meeting organizer, the meeting remains in your calendar, and you're notified by email that the invitee has accepted. Note that I've added another Outlook account for the purposes of this exercise. You won't normally be able to view both sides of a meeting request. Use the tentative option to tentatively accept the meeting invitation and place the meeting on your calendar, showing as tentative. You can choose to tentatively accept and send a response, tentatively accept and not send a response, or tentatively accept and edit the response to include information in a message to the meeting organizer. The tentative response would most likely be used in situations when you are not a required attendee, or to indicate that you may be able to attend the meeting. Use the Decline option to decline a meeting invitation. You have the same options for declining as Accept or Tentative. With Decline, it's sometimes a good idea to add a reason for your absence. If necessary, you can double-check the date and time of a meeting invitation by opening your response in the Sent Items folder. You can also propose a new time if you cannot attend the meeting at the time scheduled. You can either tentatively accept the meeting and propose a new time, or decline the meeting and propose a new time. If you do not choose either option, tentative or decline, and simply choose propose new time, by default, you tentatively accept the meeting. Verify that the attendees are free and available to meet during the time you select. By default, the new proposed time is sent to only the meeting organizer. This gives the organizer an opportunity to accept the proposed time This gives the organizer an opportunity to accept the proposed time or counter with a different time before the meeting is updated on all attendees' calendars. The meeting is placed on your calendar at the time you proposed, until the meeting organizer accepts or rejects your proposed time. Note that you can also simply reply or forward a message. These options do not pertain to the meeting invite. When you choose one of these response options, the meeting request is not accepted or declined. You've learned about the various meeting response options as an invitee and meeting organizer.